Hello, welcome back student. In up to two videos we have completed the morphology of reproductive part of inflorescence and flower. In this video we are going to see the last point of morphology of reproductive part, that is the fruit. Most of students listen about the fruit. Anybody guess what is the fruit, how the definition arises of a fruit? The fruit, it is nothing but the mature or the ripe ovary form after the fertilization. It is called as a fruit. Simply definition, mature or the ripe ovary after the fertilization is called as a fruit. The ovary wall, after the fruit formation, the ovary wall is converted into pericarp and ovule is converted into seed. Then definition, fruit is developed from the ripened ovaries or the single flower whole inflorescence. Ovary is developed into fruit, ovary wall developed into pericarp and the ovule is developed into seed. What is function of fruit? The protection for the seed, nourishment of seed on seed during development, insurance of a seed, distribution of when they are mature. The fruit is defined as mature and the ripe ovary and the seed possessing the embryo. What is the fruit formation? How fruit formation will be take place? When the reproductive organ should be mature, after the maturing organ, then pollination is needed. The transfer of pollen grain from the anther to stigma, after pollination, then fertilization will be take place. Fertilization, it is nothing but the fusion of a male gamete with the female gametes. After the fertilization, the egg is converted into zygote, the zygote is converted into embryo, and embryo is converted into seed. The ovary is converted into fruit and the ovule is converted into seed. That are the overall process. Here we see the anther. From the anther it produces the pollen grain. From the pollen grain is terminated, pollination, pollen tube develop, then fusion of a male and female gamete, zygote develop into embryo, and embryo into fruit into seed, and seed into new plant. Same process are given. Sometimes ovary may be grows into fruit without fertilization, that is known as the parthenocarpic fruit. We can see there is a seedless fruit, it is nothing but the there is no fertilization occurring in that fruit, due to which seed are not formed, and that fruit is known as the parthenocarpic fruit. Before the learning that fruit types, we have to know what is gynoecium, what is syncarpus and what is apocarpus. In previous video I will explaining a flower. Syncarpus, it is nothing but the multiple carpel are present, but they are represent in a fused condition. And apocarpus, multiple carpel are present, but they are an unfused condition. That means carpels are in a free condition. They first generally fruit are classified in true fruits and false fruit. The fruit derived from the gynoecium only, that is known as the true fruits. The fruit develop from the other floral walls, such as the sepal, petals and the another part, that is known as a false fruit. For example, apple, that is a false fruit, and mango, it is a true fruits. The parts of fruit. The fruit are there parts of fruit. Pericarp, seed. Seed are classified into testa, endosperm and the embryo. Pericarp is epicarp, mesocarp and the endocarp. Next is the classification of fruit. Fruit are classified into four types: simple, fleshy, aggregate and the multiple. The simple type are classified into indehiscent and dehiscent. That are the simple, simple type are classified into dry fruit and the fleshy fruit. Dry fruit are classified into indehiscent, dehiscent, and the fleshy are classified into their four types. Then aggregate. Aggregate is nothing but the eteroovaries and the follicles, and multiple, synchronous and the sorosis. Simple, in generally we can say there are the three types only: simple, aggregate, multiple. But most of the conversation, most of the their criteria they have classified into four types. For that purpose, simple type, the fruit are developed from the single flower, single carpel. That is why simple. Aggregate, one flower with a mini carpel, that is known as a aggregate. And multiple, the whole inflorescence is converted into fruit. Let's see simple fruit. It is developed from the single ovary, single carpel. Ovary may be simple, syncarpous, unilocular, multilocular. The pericarp of simple or modified. On the basis of pericarp, simple fruit are classified into dry and the fleshy. That means on the basis of only pericarp, they are classified into two types, dry and the fleshy. Dry fruit, the pericarp of that fruit, it is a dry, and that is known as a dry fruits. They are classified into two fruits, indehiscent and the dehiscent. Indehiscent, the wall of fruit remains unbroken at the maturity. When fruit wall is a dry, such fruit is known as a dry indehiscent. You can see figure dehiscent and the indehiscent. We can remember most of times that asteraceae family member of a seed, it will not broken. That entire fruit comes out, but that pod will be not broken, or the fruit will be not broken. And dehiscent, like a nuts, that pod will be broke. Then types of fruits, indehiscent. There is a akene. The fruit are small one-seeded, develop from the superior monocarpillary ovary. The pericarp of fruit and the testa of seed remains free from each other. For example, nilambo or coconut. Cypsela, it is a dry fruit, indehiscent fruit, one-seeded fruit, seed having the hair-like outgrowth, fruit forming the bicarpillary inferior ovary. Testa and pericarp are the separated. Testa means seed covering and the pericarp means fruit covering. This type of character are important for the family Asteraceae. Next, nut, one-seeded, large fruit, developed from the multicarpillary ovary, hard, woody pericarp, for example, crocus. Caryopsis, the fruit also developed from the simple monocarpillary superior ovary, but pericarp of fruit and the testa of seed are fused together and the inseparable, for example, maize. Dehiscent, it is simply the wall of fruit will be broke at the maturity. The fruit wall is a dry. Such fruit is known as a dry dehiscent fruit. First is a legume. All pod plant are the dehiscent type of fruit or the legume. It is a dry fruit, one chamber fruit, which dehiscent when with the two longitudinal sutures. Superior ovary with a marginal placentation. Fruit is also pod type of fruit. In this figure we can see there is a two longitudinal sutures. With the help of that, pod will be break and the seed comes outside. Next is the follicle. The fruit derived from the monocarpillary superior ovary. The fruit derived from the single carpel and the break by the open along only one sutures. In follicle, there is sac-like structure and that seed are stored. For example, calotropis. Capsule, it is simply dry dehiscent fruit. It is a developed from the polycarpillary, syncarpous, unichamber or the multichamber ovary. It is dehiscent by various way, depending on the dehiscence. It is classified loculicidal, septicidal, septifragile and curcumsicidal. Then what is a septicidal, loculicidal? In this, capsule dehisces along with the longitudinal line in between the suture, open the chamber and fruit. In case of placenta, remains attached and the fruit give that seed become outside. That is known as a capsule, loculicidal. Septicidal, the fruit dehisces with a longitudinal along with septa, so that the chamber of fruit gets separated without exposing the seed. Directly placenta come outside or the septum come outside. Septifragile, it dehiscence occur septicidal or the loculicidal, so as the seed leaves on the central axis, due to which the fruit wall become a break or the open but seed remains as it is on the central axis. Loculicidals, septicidals, and the septifragal. Curcumsicidal, the capsule dehiscence transversely, and the upper parts of a fruit become a separate like a lid, leaving the lower part like a cup with a seed. This type of fruit is called as a pyxis or the pyxidum. In this dehiscence is simple, transversely, and the upper parts of fruit become a separate like a lid opening. In this figure we can see there is a fruit upper part of it is a remaining like a lid and the seed comes outside. Next is a fleshy fruit. The fleshy fruit, it is nothing but the their flesh, pericarp is a fleshy in nature or bulbous or the pulpy in nature. That are classified pericarp into three, epicarp, mesocarp, endocarp. Epicarp, it is the outermost wall of fruit and it is generally leathery and color. Mesocarp, it is the middle layer of a pericarp which is a fleshy and the pulpy fibrous. Endocarp, it is the innermost part of layer. Pericarp may be leathery or the membranous or stony. That are simple characterization of a fleshy fruit. Then classification of fleshy fruit are given. First we see the drupe fruit. It is simple fleshy fruit developed from the monocarpillary or multicarpillary ovary. Epicarp forms the skin, mesocarp form the fibrous, and the endocarp are the heart. For example, mango, coconut are included in that. Berry, it is a fleshy fruit developed from monocarpillary or multicarpillary, syncarpus superior or inferior ovary. Epicarp forms the skin of fruit, mesocarp and endocarp forms the pulp, and in that pulp seeds are scattered. Then pome, it is a simple fleshy false fruit. In this, ovary is surrounded by the edible fleshy receptacle. Here actual ovule is a non-edible. This is typical fruit in the family Rosaceae. Next is pepo. In this type of fruit having the hard thick skin, that is known as a exocarp. It is also known as a rind. Receptacle completely partially enclosed with the ovary. Found in family Cucurbitaceae. Example watermelon. Next is Hesperidium. The fruit derived from the polycarpillary multilocular superior ovary. The seed are arranged on the axile placentation. Fleshy fruit, hard leathery pericarp. For example, orange. Aggregate fruit, the fruit are in a bunch. Fruit is a bunch of a fruitlet. It is developing from the single flower. It is with a polycarpillary apocarpus condition. Each fruitlet is known as a iterio. Iterio berries, fruitlet are a single seeded, fruitlet are a separate. Some fruitlet are fused to form a composite structure, for example, anana. Iterio follicle, the fruitlet dehiscence by their dorsal sutures and the group are elongated on a thalamus, for a champaka. Multiple fruit, the fruit develop from a many flower or the entire inflorescence. This fruit consists of many ripe ovary. The fruit develop from a many flower, for that purpose it is known as a multiple fruit. In that first sorosis, it is this type of multiple fruit developed from the spikes or spadix or catkin type of a inflorescence. All flowers are grown around the central rachis that produces the sorosis type of a fruit. The seed and juicy perianth are an edible part of a fruit. In pineapple, the inflorescence is spike, bract is surrounding the fertilized ovary and the covering of a fruit. While the perianth and the inflorescence become a massive and a fleshy. The crown of pineapple may be series of the empty bract. In cat, we can see that. Jackfruit, ovaries of the several envelope of a flower in a spadix inflorescence united to forming the spiny covering of a fruit and the edible part of fleshy perianth sticky and the hairs are nothing but a bracteal axis woody. Cinconus, the fruit are formed from the entire hypanthodium inflorescence. In fig and ficus, the female fleshy flower at the base. The opening of fruit is known as the ostiole. Entire receptacles along with the tiny flowers and become a edible part of fruit. For example, fig. Thank you. This video is made from the www.google.com/slideshare.com and special reference FYBSC Botany paper second morphology and anatomy book of success publication.